Hi, I'd like to quickly give you a tutorial on how to basically add an admin view to the front end of your site so that there can be editing and submission of the front end of this specific admin view. Now, to illustrate this, I'm going to use the public version of JCB, and it has this demo version in it. So basically, first I'll just compile it and install it to the local Joomla website so we can see what happens. And then install it and then basically open it. So here we have the demo version that is publicly available, and it basically has a admin view called looks. So if you go to the list view of the admin view called looks, you'll see there is none. We create new, and then there is basically a description box, a more item where you can click and see some custom fields and fields being built, email, mobile, birth, image, website, and your normal publish and permission structure for the view and a name field. Now, that's basically what I refer to as the admin view. It's this combination of fields working together in one view. Now, what I'll show you is how to add this editing area, basically these three tabs, to the front end of your site so that it will function like a form. Now, who you would allow to access the form will be dependent upon the permission structure. You see, the permission structure is what actually controls who can edit and who can add items to a specific admin view. So currently, as you can see, your public cannot actually edit this. If we created an item, they cannot edit it. So there's an item level on permissions. And if I close out of this, then you will see here in options, there is also a global control on permissions. So the global control of permissions is also, if you want public to be able to submit to this form, you need to allow them to be able to create. So you'd say allow. And now the public is allowed to create, and you'll see that usually most components has more than one view. This one only has one. It's called look. So you'll also have to over here say allow, and if you want them to edit existing submissions, then there is the edit state, edit own, created by, all these things in the global spec as well as in the local edit of the view. So there's basically two switches here. One is a global switch and one that is specifically focusing on the view. So if you cannot access the view on the front end after we've created it, it is actually would need to come back to this area and sort out the permissions for the specific group who should have access to the specific view on the front end. Okay, so this is what this permissional structure is quite intense and extendable, so that you can target specific groups with specific permissions and so forth for every view that JCB builds in the admin as well as site. Okay, so let me cancel out of here. I'm not gonna make any further changes here. So we're basically in the demo component. Now I'm going to go back to JCB, and basically I'm going to flip one switch, and then JCB will actually develop or write the code for the site end of this component. So I'm going back to JCB, going to components, and I'm opening the component. And now in the component, there is an area called settings, where obviously all your admin views are linked, right? So I'm going to open that. Now, usually there's a little bug in Joomla, which if you open it the first time, it doesn't reflect the original setting. So I'll usually just open it, cancel it, and then open it again, and you'll see that the original setting is back. And you'd see here that Edit Create Site View must be set to yes. If it's set to yes, then it means that it's going to create a site view of this look as so that you can edit it on the site end and not only in the admin area. And that also means create items. So I'm just going to save this and then also save and close. And then go back to compiler. Compile demo. Let's leave that off. Go. Install it. Now let's go look at the code. So looking at the demo website's folder structure, we're going to go to components, and then we'll see that there is a com underscore demo folder, and we will see there's the modules as well as the controllers as well as the views. So there is basically this is the view that was dynamically generated by JCB, the view called look, and then the model also called look, and the controller. Now you can open that to actually see what was the code that was written. And so as you can see, it basically looks very similar to the admin area, except that it's been slightly modified for your front end and its requirements. As you can see, we are adding some CSS classes and JavaScript from the back end. And then here's the the model. Basically, get item, get form, and then here is the controller. Okay, so we're just showing you the code, just basically what was created. Now, the fact that this was created doesn't mean that there is actually now a set of links that you can click and edit the forms which was submitted, or that there is a link to create any. So these things is what you would need to do manually. Now, so let's show you some of that. So as you can see, there is two views here in called on the site views, and one is called looks and the other one is called looking. As you can remember, the one we looked at here, which I said was automatically generated, is called look. So that one isn't actually showing because it was just that tick box that created this whole view, model, and controller. So you don't need to build the look view again, but you need to get links to it. Okay, so in looks we are using a dynamic get, and in looking as well. So let's go to the dynamic get page. So there's one called looks and looking. So let's go to the looks by dynamic get. So as you can see, here is the dynamic get for the looks, and it's got a custom script area where basically we're asking whether the items are set, where there are items, and then we're looping through them. And during the looping process, we basically determine by this can do script here. You'll see in the helper class there's a get action function, and the get action function asks whether the look item, or if the current user has the edit option to the specific look item. And if it does, it actually in this little script here, it builds an edit look button and dynamically adds it to the edit link, which is coupled to the item, and then just continues on. So it basically dynamically generates the button for edit here in the dynamic get. Now you could have done that anywhere. I just decided to do it here because then it actually gets added to the model, which is more where your logic fits. for lots of your data structures should be placed. And okay, so now if you go back to this, to the views, the site views, and we open the looks site view, you see that we got the main get set as looks, and here if we scroll down, we are basically in this area here, we are looping through the look items and echoing the edit link after the description. And that means now the link that we built here in the dynamic get, which is a button, will either be empty and therefore show nothing if the user doesn't have the permission to edit it, or it will actually show a button. You'll also see there is currently, as I look at this, I haven't actually added a link for creating new looks. And the same would be required to do that. So you could use the same button script, just copy that, and here at the head of the before the table, you could add a button to create new looks. Now, all you would need to change is basically this link here, that it will have an ID to 0. And then it will actually create a new look. So that's a quick tutorial on how to add an editable admin view to the site end of your component, and then link it into your site view so that you can basically click on a button and edit a specific ID view or create more, and then control that with this getAction helper class method, which gives you basically whether it can be edited. You can go look at this helper class in the code. So let me just quickly open that for you. So here in the code and helpers, we open demo PHP, and we scroll down until we get the method called getAction. Where is it now? Okay, here it is. GetAction, around 540, depends on how much custom scripting there has been added. And you can go through this logic to see that we are dealing with a number of concepts and trying to determine the permissional to edit, own, and to create, and so forth. And it all gets stored and given back to you, basically, in the result set. Okay, so you could also just echo out the result, a var dump or something, in the look to see exactly what is the result that you get from that structure. So if we go back to the looks here, view, let's just open that model. You'll see that the custom scripting we looked at basically gets added here from JCB, that custom scripting that creates the button. So you could come in here and you can just add a var dump exit and take this can do and log in as any kind of user on the site, and then when you basically load the page, it should show you the can do list of that specific user group. Also keep in mind that here is the authority setting that is applicable to the looks site view, and it's also controlled in the permission structure. So there's a lot of permissions automatically being added to components built in JCB, and you need to always keep that in mind. It might look like things don't work, while it actually works very well, you just haven't kept in mind that there is a permissional structure and that you need to adapt that permissional structure as it's fitting to your project. Okay, well, thank you for watching. Hope this helps.